It's that time again, time for another midweek video. Midweek video number 12, three ways to disinfect water and make it safe while in the backcountry. Let's get to it. Three simple ways to disinfect water and make it fit for consumption while in the backcountry. Basically, the water has to be safe for you or you die. Why? Because water is life. Without water, you're done. Common sense. And if the water makes you sick, there are certain diseases and infections that you can get where you'll wish you were dead. It's a slow death and it sucks, okay? Off the top of my head, there's two key terms. There's actually three, but there's two key terms that people tend to interchange and swap out where you know what they mean, but they use the wrong term. One is disinfect, the other is purify. The third one is called straining, where they confuse with filtration. So we'll talk about those real quick here, and then we'll get her done. The first key term I want to talk about is straining. I want to strain the water before I actually boil it or filter it. People often confuse this with pre-filtering or filtering. When you filter something, you're actually purifying it by removing all of the contaminants. Okay, so we're not gonna remove any contaminants that can cause us to be sick. All we're gonna do is get the large floaters out, the leaves. You might see some moss on there. So we're going to strain the water prior to actually disinfecting or purifying it. To do that, I have a 3x3 cotton chamog. It could be a 2x2 bandana, it could be a t-shirt. It could be anything that water can pass through it. All we're gonna do is we're gonna place it over the lid of our bottle, like so, and then simply place it into our creek. Any large contaminants, meaning like large floaties, things like that, will be stopped and not be able to enter the bottle. That is called straining. I want to strain my water prior to disinfecting or purifying it. Why? Because I don't want to boil water with crap floating inside of it. Also, if I'm going to use a filter to purify, it may clog my filter. So straining is always a good option. Now for the main key term that's present in the title of this video, disinfect. When you disinfect something, you render inert or kill the viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and parasites. Everything is still present in that water. The water can look like crap, taste like crap, smell like crap, but it's 100% safe and fit for human consumption. Now I'm going to show you two chemical ways to do that, and then one way that's common sense, and that's boiling. Let's stick with the chemicals first. This first chemical way of disinfecting water during an emergency or while in the backcountry is tincture of iodine 2%. You can find this at Walgreens, you can find it at CVS, find it at Kroger's, you can find it at any store that has a pharmacy. It is multi-purpose. It can treat wounds as well, so it's good to have something like this in your backpack in case you get hurt. You can also disinfect the water. All we're going to do here, and well, by the way, it actually comes with an eyedropper, okay? 5 to 10 drops per U.S. quart. Start off with 5 for clear water. That's not muddy and all messed up. Go ahead and put 5 drops in there. Wait 30 minutes and you should be in business. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Household bleach. We're looking at the back of this here. We're looking for sodium hypochlorite. Between 6% and 8%, and you'll be good to go. Now, this is the most controversial method. People see this and they say, you're gonna poison someone. And they say that because they're uneducated. When you turn on your faucet in your, let's say your bathroom or your shower, let it, you know, the water heat up, you can smell chlorine. That's because the water treatment plant down the street chooses to use sodium hypochlorite or a chemical that's similar to that in the water to disinfect it. So you're drinking it anyways. And it's also controversial because who carries bleach with them out in the woods? They don't. Now, how do we use the sodium hypochlorite between 6% and 8% and not poison ourselves? Well, the solution is in the dilution. So think of it like this, 2 drops per US quart, 8 drops per US gallon. We're gonna wait 30 minutes, crack the lid, dribble over the threads, and you're in business. One of the many drawbacks to using sodium hypochlorite in a bleach container is that, unlike the tincture of iodine 2%, there is no built-in dropper. So we have to improvise one in the field. Moving on to the most preferred method by the CDC and by bushcrafters and survivalists alike, it's boiling. You're going to simply boil that water. The question is, how long? So, for elevations that are 6,500 feet and below, you're going to boil the water for 1 minute. 6,500 feet and above, you're going to boil it for 3 minutes. And that's going to eliminate or kill all viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and parasites that are present in that water. We've talked about boiling point at elevations, and here's the reasoning behind that. Prior to water boiling, you hit 165 degrees Fahrenheit. That is the pasteurization process. If you were to hold that temp for 45 minutes, all viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and parasites will be eliminated. But since water can boil in like 2 minutes, you're skipping past the pasteurization and going right to boiling. So once it boils, a rapid rolling boil where the bottom is being churned upwards in aggravated bubbles, large bubbles are just coming to the surface for 1 minute at that elevation, or 3 minutes at a higher elevation, you're in business. Let's go ahead and talk about what boiling and those two chemicals do not kill or render inert. Any type of pharmaceutical waste, any type of radiation, any type of petroleum-based products, fertilizers, things like that, pesticides. Now that's where a filter comes into play. And you know, I've heard the argument or the statement, I'd filter first, then I'd boil. Well, you gotta think about that. Filters are based on microns, meaning the filter size of what can pass through that filter. And I believe it's 0.01 all the way up to 0.00001, where it takes out viruses, and then even smaller than that, they take out the radiation. On the filter itself, it tells you what it removes. Most filters do not remove radiation. Most do not remove chemicals such as pesticides. You have to read your filter. Now, most of the time, if it removes radiation and pharmaceuticals and petroleum, it's going to remove everything else as well, the viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and parasites. So if you're going to filter first, then boil, one, you're wasting time. Two, you're smoking out a filter that maybe you don't need to worry about radiation, only these four down here, in which case boiling will take care of that. So why smoke out a filter when this will suffice? So you gotta weigh it out, think about it. If the filter's only good for say 100 or 1,000, or some of them are only worth 50 uses, do I wanna waste a use when boiling will suffice? All right, so go ahead and wrap this bad boy up. We talked about straining versus pre-filtering. You're not pre-filtering anything while you're using a bandana or a shemagh. You are straining large contaminants that you can see from your water source. Disinfect versus purify. When you disinfect something, you are simply rendering inert or killing viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and parasites. Purify, we think of a filter. You are removing viruses, bacteria, protozoa, parasites, radiation, pharmaceuticals, chemical waste, moon dust, etc., etc. Buy one filter that does everything, or simply carry a couple of chemicals or boil that water. With that, all the gear in my videos can be found in three places. One, my Amazon influencer page, and two, my Self-Reliance Outfitters influencer page, and three, my Etsy page. All three links can be found inside my description box. Now please do me that favor. Hit that like and subscribe button, then ring that notification bell. Once you ring that bell, please select all notifications. And as always, thank you for your comments, views, and support. Thanks for watching. Get out in the field, have some fun. I'm gonna catch you next time.